In this demo, I'm going to walk you through the installation and configuration of VMware Site Recovery for VMware Cloud on AWS. That process is going to include activating the service, downloading the components that we need for on-premises, configuring the firewall, installing vSphere application, installing Site Recovery Manager, and then configuring vSphere application. So let's get started. Start with activating the service. This is going to, in the background, install and configure Site Recovery Manager and vSphere application within the VMware Cloud on AWS environment. That's including IP addresses and all related configurations, certificates, things like that. While that process is going on, that's a fully automated process, we can download the components that we're going to need for our on-prem installation. That would be vSphere application and Site Recovery Manager. After we get those components downloaded, we can configure the firewall. The firewall configuration consists of four rules that need to be entered. Those rules are documented both in the documentation for VMware Site Recovery as well as in the inline help for VMware Site Recovery. Once those rules are created, we would move on to installing vSphere application. This is done with an OVF and is pretty much a standard OVF installation. So it consists of selecting the OVF, selecting where we're going to install that, accepting license agreements, putting what data store we're going to install it in, what network we're going to connect it to, NTP servers, passwords, networking properties like gateways, domain names, DNS servers, the IP address for the appliance, and the mask. While that process completes, we'll move on to installing Site Recovery Manager. Site Recovery Manager is installed on a Windows server and is, again, a very basic installation. Mostly consists of clicking Next, typing in a little bit of information as needed, selecting a database. I would highly encourage you to use the embedded database that's supported and included with Site Recovery Manager. And all in all, that installation should take no more than 5 to 10 minutes to get running and go through. After that's completed, we can finish configuring vSphere application. And that's going to consist of changing a couple of things and putting in a password and then saving and restarting services. Once that's complete and our services are running, we'll be able to access the VMware Site Recovery console through vCenter. And now we're ready to pair up our sites.
So to pair up our sites, we're going to select the vCenter, enter in the PSC name for our VMware Cloud on AWS instance, username and password, select that vCenter, select the services that we want to pair, and we're done. Got the sites paired up, log in. We can see details about the Site Recovery Manager pairing as well as the vSphere application pairing. And now we just need to configure our mappings. So first off, we'll do network mappings. Go ahead and select the single network that we want to map to our VMC on AWS instance and add that. Then we'll configure it in reverse, configure our test network, and we're good to go. Move on to our folders. We're going to use the automatic mapping here. Go ahead and just select the top level, and it's going to match up anywhere where it finds the same name. Go ahead and configure those in reverse, and we're ready to complete that. Lastly, for mappings, we'll configure our resource mappings. Go ahead and set that up. Select our cluster at our on-prem location and our compute resource pool within VMC and AWS. Configure it in reverse. Configure our placeholder data store. At this point, we are ready to start protecting VMs. This concludes our demonstration of installing and configuring VMware Site Recovery.